and I'm glad to be joined on set by one Nicholas Abala. But I need him to introduce himself to our viewers. Asante sana Nicholas, your debut on KUTV. This is one of the most amazing, I must say, number one sports show in the country right now. A good platform, but kidogo, introduce yourself to us.
First of all, thank you for the opportunity. Mm-hmm. It's actually, I think you're actually the first TV show to actually host.
Yes.
University TV show to actually host university publicity for the women's teams.
Yeah.
Basically, what I do, I work with Kenya Rugby Union, mm-hmm, as a development manager, mm-hmm, and basically what I do is, I do age grade rugby that involves both under 19 girls and, yes, under 19 boys. Mm-hmm. And also, I'm in charge of the women's rugby. So what I do is basically I coordinate all the activities, mm-hmm, across the country. That entails actually coming up with fixtures, ensuring that the game actually develops. Other than that, I also wear another different hat, yeah, whereby I'm a Get Into Rugby manager. Mm-hmm. Get Into Rugby is a world rugby program whereby they market the game by using the three tenets of try, play, and stay.
Yeah.
So basically, you trade the game in a safe and actually more acceptable way for people who don't have any idea about rugby,
mm-hmm,
and then to a level where by now you can play and actually stay.
Mm.
Yeah,
quite impressive, I must say.
Exactly.
I know we are here to talk about the women rugby, but kidogo, I feel na dungo. I need to ask you something.
Please,
what is happening in Sydney? What is your take on it? We've lost all our matches. What is happening?
Basically, you know, it's always when new crop of players are coming in,
yeah,
there'll always be that part whereby chemistry, experience, and such, yeah, like stuff will actually, yeah, take time. So the team we have is actually a very good team.
Mm.
Yeah, it's a very good team. It's also a very young team,
mm-hmm,
with a few very experienced old players.
Mm-hmm.
But if you look at it in general, they have actually played well. It's, mm-hmm, only that just the small things, the, mm-hmm, finishing touch of it,
mm-hmm,
is that is what is missing, but that takes time.
Mm-hmm.
So I believe we should keep on backing our team and just supporting them, and with time, definitely that will change.
All right.
Yes.
Yes, I was actually pained when Mike Friday's team, Ilitupiga, you know, I didn't like that. But let's go back to our discussion. 10-a-side women, first,
yeah,
of all.
Yeah.
What is this all about?
This actually, it's, we'll say, it's the main, it's more of as if the main league for the women.
Yeah.
Basically, it started in 2015, and it has been taking baby steps, and we can say this is the fourth edition.
Yeah.
Actually, the first university side was USIU, and then now we had Kenyatta University come in. And slowly by slowly, we're seeing other universities following through. We've seen Masinde Maliro University come in. We've seen Egerton University come in. We've, mm-hmm, seen Chuka University come in. So it's just a matter of time before I think we are going to be having a university league,
yeah,
or festival, like the one they normally have, KUSA for boys.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So this is actually the fourth edition. And we have nine main teams, KU being one of the nine main teams.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, then since the numbers increased, we are doing it over one day, we've decided to put in some space whereby we have the two extra teams that are coming in, that is Egerton University and Chuka University,
mm-hmm,
can also have a chance to actually showcase what they have.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Well, I see this being the fourth edition, we have a couple of good things
yes,
coming up, including,
yeah,
a majority of universities now are taking up the women rugby very well. But in general, because you're in the development of women rugby, how is it, what's the state of women rugby in Kenya?
First of all, I have to say that we really need to publicize what is actually happening. People don't know that the Kenya Lioness, that is the women's seven-a-side team, are actually the African champions, the 2018 African champions. And if you look at it, the way they've been playing, it shows that actually they're going somewhere. They were actually at Rio in the Olympics. So rugby sevens now is an Olympic sport. And we've been trying to see how the Kenya Secondary School Sports Association can actually include the girls rugby in their tournaments. Because I believe the Sports Act 2013, if I'm not wrong, says whereby when you have a boy playing one game, you also need to have girls playing the other one. And looking at the steps that Kenya Rugby Union has actually done, you see that I think since 2015, when we showcased first edition of the high school sevens rugby, Now we are having about 200 girls schools playing the sport. So if 200 girls schools have actually tried the sport, and in certain regions you find you have more than 40 girls schools playing, that shows you that actually the number could be slightly higher in certain regions than for even for hockey. So that gives us hope that something is going to be done soon. The Kenya Secondary School Sports Association will actually look into it and include the girls playing actually in their tournaments. Mm-hmm. And then other than that one, we're really trying to work with universities, mm-hmm. because I think it's the right way to go. Universities have facilities, and then apart from that one, universities have numbers. Mm-hmm. So that is the current state where we basically have 10 core teams, if I might put it that way, yeah. Because basically we know nine have been actually very active. Then one has actually slackened off a bit. That is USIU. They have slackened off a bit, but they're still working to see how they can come back and rejoin mm-hmm. actually the journey. Yes.
You said something very important when you talk about the secondary school games. Exactly. They're not featuring the girls' rugby. Mm-hmm. Also, Kusa, there was a time we were featuring them live. Peter Mora was actually live and actually asked why they didn't have a women version of the same. Why do you think this has been the case, and not only in rugby, but I think it's in a majority of sporting disciplines, the women sports seems to be dragging as compared to their male counterparts?
I think, first of all, I'll say from my own opinion and perspective, yeah. is that there's that old way of thinking mm-hmm. that ladies cannot do certain things.
Yeah.
And actually, if you look at it, look at 3 years and you're already having like 200 girls' schools actually playing the game.
Yeah.
That shows you that all that ladies need is just to be given a chance.
Yeah.
Give them a chance and they'll play.
Mm-hmm.
And also given that it is how the sport was being introduced, mm-hmm. probably, that is normally the issue. But now with us, we have the Get Into Rugby program, which yeah. is a world rugby program that takes you from a point whereby basically if you don't know how to play it,
yeah.
to a level whereby you actually know how to mm-hmm. play the game.
Mm-hmm.
So you'll either end up staying either as a match official, as a coach, as a medical personnel, yeah. or even as an analyst,
yeah.
or even as a fan.
Yeah.
So basically, me, I think is the mindset, the old mindset of people. But with time, the way things are changing, it shows that all the ladies need is just to be given a chance.
Mm-hmm.
That's all.
All right.
Yes.
Given a chance. Your last words, especially to people who are involved in nurturing women in rugby.
Yeah. I believe if we ensure that as many women as possible participate in rugby, definitely you know that the next generation will mm-hmm. definitely participate into rugby.
Mm-hmm.
So by having more women participating in rugby, it shows that the next generation will definitely
mm-hmm.
be in rugby and the numbers will actually increase.
Mm-hmm.
rugby is a sport of a lot of values,
yeah.
Teamwork, respect, honesty. So basically, if those values can be inculcated into the next generation,
yeah.
then not only will just rugby be as a sport,
yeah.
but also it will actually change our society.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mr. Nicholas,
yes.
such a pleasure having you on set. I believe we need to have you back on set because we need to talk about women in rugby. Personally, I need to look for you because I am passionate about women in sports, and we'll be doing that very soon. Well, we've been talking to Nicholas Abalia on what will be happening. That is the Tenaside Women Festival. It will be happening right here at Kenyatta University. Kahuko na mpango, sasa tumekupea mpango. Come out, support our girls because we need to support women in sports.